Justice never attend. Sorry, I had to do this. Why do this every time on my here great days? So, thank you guys for tuning in. This will be the last part of the review. So here I'll give my final thoughts on it and the verdict. So it's gonna be kind of biased, but hopefully it's pretty close to actual criticism. Okay, so Diamond is unbreakable, part 4, or Diamond is not Crash, whichever version you prefer to call it. So, as I said before, it is my favorite part in all of JoJo's. And why? Well, it's because of the mystery that the story presents about this unknown killer who is just murdering and getting away with it. So, the mystery, that's why I love shows such as Scooby-Doo and Sherlock, because there is the sense of mystery over there. The suburban setting. I love the suburbs. I basically live in the suburbs, not too outside of the main city. I live in the suburbs, so I consider myself a lucky kid. So I love the suburbs. I love the setting. It's in 1990 and takes place in 1999, which is 10 years after Stardust Crusaders. And I was basically one when Diamond is Unbreakable took place. I was born in September 19, 1997. So the setting is very nice. The friendship between the characters, especially Okuyasu and Josuke, is pretty memorable. It's basically bro goals at this point. Bro goals. Why watch it? Because of it, they get two of them, and the friendship, and Koichi is there, and they work as a trio. They work a lot as a trio, but Koichi, he gets a girlfriend. This is basically the two for them. Subs now, so they just lost the bro, but not actually, since they are there for each other. But still, the three of them, it goes to one of the funniest parts in the bad translation, the Chinese student translation, which is Josuke just says, Koichi stealing? No dignity. I sometimes use that because I find it pretty funny. The return of the previous JoJo's, the first character who we are introduced to in the anime, or that we are being reintroduced to, is Jotaro. And he's great in part 4. He's better than in part 3, in my opinion. So he's best part 6, but sometimes my thoughts clash. But sometimes I think part four Jotaro is better than part 6. At times. So I need to refresh myself on Stone Ocean. I'm way ahead of you guys. I'm waiting for part 7 anime. So yeah, I'm totally ahead of you. Yeah, the return of previous JoJo's. Oh, Joseph. My gosh, I actually cried when he came back. This character, if you see by the name of this channel, this character, he means a lot to me. We saw him in his youth. We saw him in his better years, in Stardust Crusaders, when he led the team. And now he's too old to engage in stand battles. You can't help yourself but have at least a tear roll down your cheek. But sometimes it makes for some hilarious moments. I may be exaggerating, but I found them pretty funny. So yes, and Josuke is gonna be my favorite JoJo. So much like Joseph in that he is manipulative. He basically strategizes, and he's like Jonathan. He's a much kinder JoJo. So perfect song to end this review in. Oh yeah, and Kira. As I said before, Araki has a trouble in writing villains better than Leo, and it lasts until part 4. I think that Kira is a better villain. It's one of the best villains. He is too good written, because he feels like a serial killer, and his character shows and the tenacity that he has, and the measures that he has to go through, he makes sure not to stand out too much. It does everything that the serial killer has to be in order to be done, in order to be non-justice. And that's it. Now for the verdict. What do I give this part? It's really hard. This is my opinion. I'm gonna give it a 10 out of 10. I like it too much. Now, is it the perfect part? Well, I don't think so. Not at all. No part in JoJo is perfect. Except for part 2. No, I'm kidding about that. I'm kidding. So no part in this perfect. Nothing is perfect in this world. There is no perfect book and no perfect movie, no perfect storyline, no perfect video game. Although The Witcher 3 is pretty much close to it. As close to it as you can get. Yeah. That and Half-Life 2. But only those exceptions. So yeah, 10 out of 10, still a low 10 out of 10. It's not a high 10 out of 10, because a high 10 out of 10 would be perfect. But yeah, I do enjoy re-watching it. And I'm gonna go on the screening on the 6th, and I'm gonna watch some of the last episodes, which I'm glad of, and the first episode of Vento Aureo. So I will watch it on the 6th, and then on the 8th, I'll give you my review, basically my thoughts on the first episode of Vento Aureo. And with that said, let the joy of love give you an answer. Let the voice of love take you higher. Thank you very much. Have a beautiful Duang, guys. This has been it for me. I think I'm gonna cry. This is emotional for me. Thank you for all your support. Means so much to me. See you guys next week. What will I give you? I don't know. I'm not a guy with a plan. Do I look like a guy with a plan? No, have a great day.